This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The 1940 Republican National Convention was held in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. From June 24 to June 28, 1940, it nominated Wendell Willkie of Indiana for president and Senator Charles McNary of Oregon for vice president. The contest for the 1940 Republican nomination was wide open. Front runners included Senator Arthur H. Vandenberg of Michigan, Senator Robert Taft of Ohio, and Manhattan District Attorney Thomas E. Dewey. Republican candidates, newspaper editor and owner Frank Gannett of New York, Governor Arthur James of Pennsylvania, House Minority Leader Joseph W. Martin of Massachusetts, Governor Harlan J. Bushfield of South Dakota, District Attorney Thomas Dewey of New York, President Herbert Hoover of California 1929-1932, Senate Charles L. McNary of Oregon, Senate Robert A. Taft of Ohio, Senate Arthur H. Vandenberg of Michigan, Wendell Willkie of New York. Contents 1. The race 2. Willkie emerges as a dark horse. 3. Balloting. 4. Bomb discoveries. 5. References. 6. Further reading. 7. External links. The race in the months leading up to the opening of the 1940 Republican National Convention. The three leading candidates for the GOP nomination were considered to be Senators Robert A. Taft of Ohio and Arthur Vandenberg of Michigan, and District Attorney Thomas E. Dewey of New York. Taft was the leader of the GOP's conservative, non-interventionist wing, and his main strength was in his native Midwest and parts of the South. Vandenberg, the senior Republican in the Senate, was the favorite son candidate of the Michigan delegation and was considered a possible compromise candidate. Dewey, the district attorney for Manhattan, had risen to national fame as the gangbuster prosecutor who had sent numerous infamous mafia figures to prison, most notably Lucky Luciano, the organized crime boss of New York City. All three men had campaigned vigorously during the primary season, but only 300 of the 1,000 convention delegates had been pledged to a candidate by the time the convention opened. Moreover, each of these candidates had weaknesses that could be exploited. Taft's outspoken non-interventionism and opposition to any American involvement in the European War convinced many Republican leaders that he could not win a general election, particularly as the French Third Republic fell to Nazi Germany in May 1940 and Germany threatened the United Kingdom. Dewey's relative youth, he was only 38 in 1940, and lack of any foreign policy experience caused his candidacy to weaken as the Nazi military emerged as a fearsome threat in 1940. Vandenberg was also a non-interventionist. He changed his foreign policy stance during World War II, and his lackadaisical, lethargic campaign never caught the voters' attention. This left an opening for a dark horse candidate to emerge. Willkie emerges as a dark horse. A Wall Street-based industrialist named Wendell Willkie, who had never before run for public office, emerged as the unlikely nominee. Willkie, a former Democrat who had been a pro-Roosevelt delegate at the 1932 Democratic National Convention, was considered an improbable choice. Willkie had first come to public attention as an articulate critic of Roosevelt's attempt to break up electrical power monopolies. Willkie was the CEO of the Commonwealth and Southern Power Company, and he opposed the federal government's attempts to compete with private enterprise, claiming that the government had unfair advantages over private companies. Willkie did not dismiss all Roosevelt's social welfare programs, and in fact supported those he believed free enterprise could not do better. Furthermore, unlike the leading Republican candidates, Willkie was a forceful and outspoken advocate of aid to the Allies, especially the United Kingdom. His support of giving all aid to the British, short of declaring war, won him the support of many Republicans on the East Coast of the United States, who disagreed with their party's isolationist leaders in Congress. Willkie's persuasive arguments impressed these Republicans, who believed that he would be an attractive presidential candidate. Many of the leading press barons of the era, such as Ogden Reed of the New York Herald Tribune, Roy Howard of the Scripps Howard newspaper chain, and John and Gardner Cowles, publishers of the Minneapolis Star and the Minneapolis Tribune, as well as the Des Moines Register and Look magazine, supported Willkie in their newspapers and magazines. Even so, Willkie remained a long-shot candidate. The May 8 Gallup poll showed Dewey at 67% support among Republicans, followed by Vandenberg and Taft, with Willkie at only 3%. The Nazi Army's rapid blitzkrieg into France in May 1940 shook American public opinion, even as Taft was telling a Kansas audience that America must concentrate on domestic issues to prevent Roosevelt from using the international crisis to extend socialism at home. both Dewey and Vandenberg also continued to oppose any aid to the United Kingdom that might lead to war with Germany. Nevertheless, sympathy for the embattled British was mounting daily, and this aided Wilkie's candidacy by mid-June, little over 1 week before the Republican convention opened. The Gallup poll reported that Wilkie had moved into second place with 17%, and that Dewey was slipping, fueled by his favorable media attention. Wilkie's pro-British statements won over many of the delegates as the delegates were arriving in Philadelphia, Gallup reported. That Wilkie had surged to 29%, Dewey had slipped 5 more points to 47%, and Taft, Vandenberg and former President Herbert Hoover trailed at 8%, 8%, and 6% respectively. Hundreds of thousands, perhaps as many as 1 million, telegrams urging support for Wilkie poured in, many from Wilkie clubs that had sprung up across the country. Millions more signed petitions circulating everywhere. Balloting at the 1940 Republican National Convention itself, keynote speaker Harold Stassen, the governor of Minnesota, announced his support for Wilkie and became his official floor manager. Hundreds of vocal Wilkie supporters packed the upper galleries of the convention hall. Wilkie's amateur status, his fresh face, appealed to delegates as well as voters. The delegations were selected not by primaries but by party leaders in each state, and they had a keen sense of the fast-changing pulse of public opinion. Gallup found the same thing in polling data not reported until after the convention. Wilkie had moved ahead among Republican voters by 44% to only 29% for the collapsing Dewey, as the pro-Wilkie galleries repeatedly yelled, "We want Wilkie." The delegates on the convention floor began their vote. Dewey led on the first ballot but steadily lost strength thereafter. Both Taft and Wilkie gained in strength on each ballot, and by the fourth ballot it was obvious that either Wilkie or Taft would be the nominee. The key moments came when the delegations of large states such as Michigan, Pennsylvania, and New York left Dewey and Vandenberg and switched to Wilkie, giving him the victory on the sixth ballot. The voting went like this: presidential balloting, RNC 1940 ballot 1 2 3 4 5 6 before shifts 6 after shifts. Wendell L. Wilkie 105,105%, 171,171%, 259,259%, 306,306%, 429,429%, 655,655%. 998,998%. Ohio Senator Robert A. Taft 189,189%, 203,203%, 212,212%, 254,254%, 377,377%, 318,318%. Thomas E. Dewey 360,360%, 338,338%, 315,315%, 250,250%, 57,57%, 11,110%. Michigan Senator Arthur Vandenberg 76-73-72-61-42, Pennsylvania Governor Arthur H. James 74-66-59-56-59, Massachusetts Rep. Joseph W. Martin 44-26. Hanford McNider 34-34-28-26-4, Frank E. Gannett 33-30-11-4-11, former President Herbert Hoover 17-21-32-31-20-10, New Hampshire Senator Stiles Bridges 28-9-11. Scattering, blank 40-29-11-11-11-5-2. Table source, Richard C. Bain and Judith H. Paris, Convention Decisions and Voting Records 1973, pp. Charles L. McNary 848 Dewey Short 108 Stiles Bridges 2. On the first ballot, Dewey was ahead, followed by Taft and Wilkie thereafter. Dewey steadily lost strength while Taft and Wilkie picked up votes on the fourth ballot. Wilkie was ahead but short of the 501 votes needed for nomination on the sixth roll call. 1 a.m. Friday, Wilkie finally went over the top. Wendell Wilkie made history too by his personal appearance at the 1940 convention. Wilkie breaks party tradition by personal appearance like Roosevelt's in 32. The New York Times headline told its readers, "Crowd goes wild greeting nominee," and "Cheers mark his every word." In the New York Times headlines convey something of the convention's mood in 1940 with Wilkie's appearance as your nominee. Wilkie told the convention in his brief appearance, "I expect to conduct a crusading, vigorous, fighting campaign. The 1940 Republican Convention also holds the distinction as the first convention carried on live television, broadcast by NBC and W2XE later KYW-TV, and seen on Pioneer stations in Philadelphia, New York and Schenectady. See also NBC bomb discoveries. Two dynamite bombs were discovered outside of the hall and a total of seven bombs were discovered in the Greater Philadelphia area during the convention. The discoveries of the bombs were inadvertently released to the public by an emotional New York City Police Commissioner Louis J. Valentine while discussing the New York World's Fair bombing that killed two police officers. References Carat 1940 GOP Convention Archive January 1, 2007. At the Wayback Machine Carrot says bombs found near GOP's Hall Reading Eagle July 11, 1940. Further reading Charles Peters 2005, 5 Days in Philadelphia, The Amazing We Want Wilkie Convention of 1940 and How It Freed FDR to Save the Western World, New York, Public Affairs. External links Republican Party Platform of 1940 at the American Presidency Project. Wilkie acceptance speech at the American Presidency Project proceeded. 1936 Cleveland, Ohio Republican National Convention succeeded. Cameron Jewell Sabin Jones Key Clarkson Carter Hannah Payne Cortelyou New Hitchcock Hill Rosewater Hills Wilcox Hayes Adams. Butler Work Houston Fess Sanders Fletcher Hamilton Martin Walsh Spangler Brownell Reese Scott Gabrielson Summerfield Roberts Hall Alcorn. T.B. Morton Miller Birch Bliss R. Morton Dole Bush Smith Brock Richards Laxalt Fahrenkopf Reagan, Fahrenkopf Atwater Uter Bond Barber Nicholson Gilmore. Racicott Gillespie Melman Martinez Duncan Steele Priebus Presidential tickets Fremont, Dayton Lincoln, Hamlin Lincoln, Johnson Grant, Colfax Grant, Wilson Hayes, Wheeler Garfield, Arthur Blaine, Logan Harrison, Morton Harrison, Reed. McKinley, Hobart McKinley, Roosevelt Roosevelt, Fairbanks Taft, Sherman Taft, Sherman, Butler Hughes, Fairbanks Harding, Coolidge Coolidge, Dawes Hoover, Curtis twice Landon, Knox Wilkie, McNary Dewey, Bricker Dewey, Warren Eisenhower, Nixon twice Nixon, Lodge Goldwater, Miller Nixon, Agnew twice Ford, Dole. Reagan, G.H.W. Bush twice G.H.W. Bush, Quayle twice Dole, Kemp G.W. Bush, Cheney twice McCain, Palin Romney, Ryan Trump, Pence parties by state and territory state Alabama Alaska Arizona Arkansas California Colorado Connecticut Delaware Florida, Georgia, Hawaii, Idaho, Illinois, Indiana, Iowa, Kansas, Kentucky, Louisiana, Maine, Maryland, Massachusetts, Michigan, Minnesota, Mississippi, Missouri, Montana Nebraska, Nevada, New Hampshire, New Jersey, New Mexico, New York, North Carolina, North Dakota, Ohio, Oklahoma, Oregon, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, South Carolina, South Dakota, Tennessee, Texas, Utah, Vermont, Virginia, Washington, West Virginia, Wisconsin, Wyoming, Territory, American Samoa, District of Columbia, Guam, Northern Mariana Islands, Puerto Rico, Virgin Islands. Conventions list 1856 Philadelphia, 1860 Chicago, 1864 Baltimore. 1868 Chicago 1872 Philadelphia 1876 Cincinnati 1880 Chicago 1884 Chicago 1888 Chicago 1892 Minneapolis 1896 St. Louis 1900 Philadelphia 1904 Chicago 1908 Chicago 1912 Chicago 1916 Chicago 1920 Chicago 1924 Cleveland 1928 Kansas City 1932 Chicago 1936 Cleveland 1940 Philadelphia 1944 Chicago 1948 Philadelphia 1952 Chicago 1956 San Francisco 1960 Chicago 1964 San Francisco 1968 Miami Beach 1972 Miami Beach 1976 Kansas City 1980 Detroit 1984 Dallas 1988 New Orleans 1992 Houston 1996 San Diego 2000 Philadelphia 2004 New York 2008 St. Paul. 2012 Tampa 2016 Cleveland Affiliated Organizations Fundraising Groups National Republican Congressional Committee National Republican Senatorial Committee Republican Conference of the United States House of Representatives Republican Conference of the United States Senate Republican Governors Association Sectional Groups College Republicans Chairman Congressional Hispanic Conference International Democrat Union Log Cabin Republicans Republican Jewish Coalition Republican National Hispanic Assembly Republicans Abroad, Teenage Republicans, Young Republicans, Factional Groups, Republican Main Street Partnership, Republican Majority for Choice, Republican Liberty Caucus, Republican National Coalition for Life, Republican Study Committee, ConservAmerica Freedom Caucus, Ripon Society. The wish list related articles. History 2009 Chairmanship Election, 2011 Chairmanship Election. Bibliography. Timeline of Modern American Conservatism. Conservatism Portal. VE United States Presidential Election, 1940 Democratic Party Convention Nominee Franklin D. Roosevelt. VP Nominee Henry A. Wallace. Candidates James Farley, John Nance, Garner Cordell Hull. Millard Tidings Republican Party Convention Nominee Wendell Willkie. VP Nominee Charles L. McNary. Candidates Stiles Bridges, Thomas Dewey, Frank Gannett, Arthur James, Robert Taft, Arthur H. Vandenberg, Norman Thomas. VP nominee Maynard C. Kruger. Socialist Labor Party nominee John W. Aiken. VP nominee Aaron M. Orange. Independents and other candidates Gracie Allen. Other 1940 elections, House, Senate.